those were, I think, incredibly meaningful videos. They do several things. They capture our common humanity. They capture the values that we share with believers in other faiths, as well as outlining the key elements of Pope Francis's papal encyclical, which is in the Catholic tradition of social teaching. And while it's true that most papal encyclicals are focused on Catholics per se, there is a tradition that goes back in terms of informing all of those. And the notion of convergence with nature is embedded in historical Catholicism, going back to St. Francis, for example, and the commonalities that we have, or going to more recent popes who've talked about global crises of the ecology. Laudato Si, subtitle, as was suggested, is Care for Our Common Home. And while in its thoroughness and drawing from science, it's really different than a lot of other kinds of comments religiously about our planet, the Pope's emphasis on nature, as I say, is not at all new. Laudato Si' principal contribution, as suggested in those 10 items, is to infuse a religious point of view into the climate change a set of issues. And they're not. I don't know where we would divide as an audience, but less than half of Americans believe there's significant climate change that's caused by human activity. Okay? It's not a done deal. It's not everybody's understanding. There are those who believe that there is global warming, but that it's episodic. Others who believe that it's not even that episodic. It's just an extraneous set of facts that won't be sustained. Both scientists otherwise have a very different kind of perspective, measuring not merely whether there's global warming in the atmosphere, but measuring the seas in an intricate array of other kind of phenomena. In any case, part of what's very importantly focused in the papal encyclical is consequences for the poor. Consequences for those who live in the third world. Consequences for the future in terms of their survival and their ability to effectively wend their way through successful lives. The Pope accepts what he considers to be a serious science. And I think that's very important. And he very interestingly criticizes some of the core concepts of capitalism, you know, some of the core notions of how we grow, how we develop, market forces, and the like, with an emphasis not on how technology benefits, but a stress on how unabated technology, unthought through technology, may be set to sail on uncharted waters. I think we have an extraordinary program this evening, starting with the music, and so thank you very much for those of you who performed. Wonderful. Thank you. We're fortunate to have three speakers who are particularly, especially knowledgeable about the environment, as well as deeply learned about the writings and beliefs of their respective faiths, about the relationship of humanity to nature. Each speaker will offer 10, 15 minutes of commentary on a set of interrelated questions that I'll note in a minute or two. Permit me, however, to introduce the three speakers all at once, and they will speak in the order that I've introduced them, unless there's something really seriously rebellious about the group. I don't know. So, following the last speaker, there'll be an opportunity for some follow-up questions. And they've each agreed to remain a while after the program is over. So to the extent you have some questions, you have something interesting to chat about, please feel free to approach them and feel free to have some light refreshments that will be outside of this room. Our first presenter is Dr. Imad Bayoun, who is widely recognized for his deep commitment to religious education, especially among Muslim youth, and as a lecturer for the Muslim American Society. He was born in Beirut, Lebanon, where he received a BS and MS from the American University of Beirut. He was awarded a PhD in entomology from Texas A&M University and a PhD in Islamic studies from the Graduate Theological Foundation. Dr. Bayoun lives in Riverside and works as the insectary and quarantine officer at UCR's entomology department. So anybody want to repeat that? No? Okay. He also teaches Arabic calligraphy at Cal State San Bernardino. Dr. Bayoun has taught the structure of jurisprudence of the Prophet's biography at the Islamic American University and has produced several audio series on purification of the heart, Muslim character, and other topics. Many of those lectures presentations are available to be downloaded from his website, and I'd encourage that. Our second speaker is the very Reverend Benedict Wachuku Udaku, a priest originally from Nigeria, ordained in 1995. He's pastor of Sacred Heart Parish, Rancho Cucamonga, and chairman of the San Bernardino Priests Presbyteral Council. He has been appointed by Bishop Barnes, and I should take a moment to say thank you to Bishop Barnes for opening this wonderful, wonderful facility for this occasion. And I can't recall if Father Manning indicated, but Reverend Barnes, Bishop Barnes, would have been delighted to be here. He happens to be in Mexico with the Pope. And so I think there's a kind of a trump card or something like that. I'm not real sure about that. So Father Ben has been appointed by Bishop Barnes to lead the promotion of Laudato Si in the diocese. After serving 6 years in his home diocese in Nigeria, Father Ben studied theology at the Jesuit University, Universidad Pontificia Comillas in Madrid, where he received a master's degree in bioethics and a PhD in moral theology. He now teaches at the Ministry Formation Institute, San Bernardino Diocese. He's also undertaken work on a postdoctoral master's degree in the School of Arts and Humanities at Claremont Graduate University. His doctoral dissertation has been published, and he's also written scholarly articles for international theological journals on the subject of environmental ethics. Our third speaker is Rabbi Michael Lotger, who's a second career rabbi, ordained in 2003 from the Hebrew Union College, Jewish Institute of Religion. He holds undergraduate and graduate degrees in physics from Queens College in New York City and from the University of Illinois, Champaign-Urbana. His first career was focused on wind, solar, and geothermal energy, and he started a number of alternative energy firms, including a wind power company that was installed and operated in Hawaii and here in California. He's widely published in the alternative energy field. Currently, he serves as rabbi of the Jewish community of Ojai and the community rabbi for the Jewish Federation of Ventura County, as well as Rabbi Emeritus at Temple Ner Ami in Camarillo. Dr. Lochter's interest in interfaith.